everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayshree this side. Today in this video tutorial, I will be sharing how to make mixed media tags using pattern papers from Dress My Craft. But before we begin, please do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos. To begin with, I have here a pattern paper from Romantic Roses paper pack and some scrap pieces of paper from Magnolia's paper pack. I have already cut the chipboard to the size of my tags, which is 6 by 3 inches. Now, using my paper trimmer from Dress My Craft, I am trimming down the extra top of the pattern paper and then sticking the chipboard tags on the back of the pattern paper. I am now just trimming down the extra paper around the tags. Next, I have here two more papers from Magnolia's paper pack trimmed down smaller than the base to make a second layer. I am now distressing the edges of these pieces. Once done distressing, I am applying a thin coat of clear gesso on the papers. It helps in sealing the paper and prevent from any seepage of paints and inks. After drying the gesso, I am using the honeycomb mixed media stencil from Dress My Craft to add some texture design in the background. Dress My Craft has 38 different mixed media stencils to choose from. These stencils are of A4 size. One thing that sets these stencils apart is the design on them. Every stencil by Dress My Craft has multiple designs going on them and makes them perfect for mixed media projects. Dries, I'm adding some color in the background. I'm using metallic acrylic paints in the shades of pink rust along with some powdered pigments in the color olive green. I'm simply spraying my base paper with some water and then adding the color onto it and moving the color around. I'm dabbing off the extra water using tissue paper. Though I'm not much bothered about adding too much water on these papers, as Dress My Craft's paper are of 280 GSM and of very high quality. They are very sturdy and wouldn't curl even if I spill too much water on them. Once done adding paints and drying them completely, I am now going to arrange my embellishments on the tags. For this, I am using a mix of clay molds, resin molds, and of course the mulberry flowers. I have already covered my embellishments in black gesso. Now, while I adhere these embellishments, why don't you hit the thumbs up button below the video if you are enjoying watching this tutorial. Also, the links to all the products used in this video are given in the description box below, so do check that out. embellishing, I'm using some metallic waxes in different colors to highlight the embellishments. I'm using the colors bronze, gold, and pink. The mulberry flowers. And as I always say, no flower arrangement is complete without foliage. So I'm using here die cuts made using foliage and leaves die set number 10 from Dress My Craft. Now to add a little bit more interest in the background, I'm stamping randomly using black archival ink and a script stamp. Lastly, I'm adding these sentiments cut out from the Magnolia's motif sheet on the dance. Here our tags are ready. I also later on ended up adding some flower pearls in the color Snow White and Black from Dress My Craft to add more interest. I hope you liked this tutorial and are inspired to make your own mixed media tags using Dress My Craft's stencils, papers and more. Before you go, don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching the tutorial and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Also, hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest videos on the channel. Until next time, happy crafting! Bye-bye!